in March, April, we did see the spike in volatility, and we managed through that. I'm not just speaking for CIBC Mellon, but I think globally, it's a very fair comment to make that we as market participants, sub-custodians, global custodians, did make sure that things did get done. We did have good collaboration within the market participants, be the CSDs with or the ICSDs with the extended deadlines where it had to, and where he had to shift around into accommodate for post-trade settlements and how we manage them. At CIBC Mellon, again, with the environment I described earlier in terms of the working from home, the ability to manage workflow between one member to the other, and more importantly, keeping our clients informed. Whenever we had such spikes or challenges, whether it be at the local market or anything otherwise, so that the client was aware of it in terms of actual settlements, there are challenges at the depository level, we got to work through that. Striking NAVs, we might have challenges with market prices coming in from different vending providers. So I think, you know, it is absolutely an important thing that we had to do, was to keep your clients informed, engaged, so that they understood the challenges that their provider is going through, and they had a element of empathy because they themselves were going through the same thing as well. Now, if you shift back or shift forward and look into the US elections coming up, maybe the second or the third wave of the pandemic coming in, it's going to be a double-edged sword we are walking here, because US elections per se might be just a volume volatility issue, which we might have learned so much from our lessons learned from March, April, May, that we'll be able to sort of include them into our model through the right technology, right workflow management. We will sort of get through that. But we should not forget now, alongside that's happening, we could potentially could have staff not being available for the second or the third wave, and how are we going to manage through that? Here it comes into a lot of planning that we have to do, is how much we can leverage between one team to the other team, internally to look through that, and more importantly, to work with the local market service providers, whether it be the CSD or other counterparties, in enhancing the element of communication to work through the flows. To me, if you ask me how we will manage the incremental volatility in the upcoming months, it's through a collaborative, cohesive way within the market participants, and also an engaged communication protocol within our clients, and more importantly, keep our staff members engaged in every step of the way, because we got to work through different moving components as part of this equation. So that's the way I would see that the upcoming volatility, if any, would come into intuition as to how we handle that.